All right, the time has come to demystify the preparation of final accounts. How is balance sheet and income statement prepared? How is profit and loss account and the balance sheet prepared? In this video, I'm going to look at the trial balance that was prepared in lecture 4.2. You can go back to that video if you like. We prepared a trial balance. Now, this trial balance was prepared based upon the 14 transactions that we used for writing the journal entries, and then we used the same 14 transactions to do the ledger posting, and we prepared the trial balance. Now we are using the same trial balance to prepare the balance sheet and profit and loss account. So we have debit balances and credit balances here. All we are going to do is pick these and place these into the two statements, income statement and balance sheet. I also have in the slide deck with me a profit and loss account format, and on the next slide I have the format of balance sheet. All right, and I also know that both these accounts follow a proper, we have to follow a sequence as well. So I'm going to mention that here as well. So on the asset side, we have to first write the non-current assets, and this is going to be followed by current assets. This is how it is supposed to be presented. On the liability side, we are going to have the shareholder capital, or we call it equity capital. And then you have non-current liabilities, and you have current liabilities. So this format has to be followed whenever you are preparing a balance sheet or of any company. As far as the income statement or the profit and loss account is concerned, you have a credit side, you have a debit side, and you know there is no specific subheads which are given. They are given in the statement format, but for the purpose of the account form of profit and loss account, we are going to be following the two sections. So let's say we segregate it here, we'll write all the direct expenses here and indirect expenses here. So let us get started. The first thing to do is to identify from this trial balance, we have to identify which of these items are incomes, expenses, assets or liabilities. The incomes and expenses are going to be taken to the profit and loss account, and assets and liabilities are going to be taken to the balance sheet. So the bank account is an asset, so I'll just write asset, and also within the assets it is a current asset. So I have identified the two categories. So bank account has to be taken to the current assets. So 210 is the amount. So under the current assets, I will write bank and I will write 210. So this is the bank balance at the end of the year when we are preparing this statement. Next item is shareholder capital, which is 100. This is a liability item, and this goes under the equity, shareholder equity or shareholder capital. So I'm going to write here shareholders capital, and this is 200. Next up you have purchase, 100. Purchase is an expense, and purchase is also a direct expense. So 100 is going to be written here, purchase. Purchases 100 during the year. This is an expense. Then you have sales. Sale is an income, and also sale is an operating income. 100 to be written in the income statement, in the profit and loss account here on the credit side at the top. Then you have ABC and PQR. There is no balance in these accounts. But if there was balance in these accounts, we know that ABC is the vendor and PQR is the customer. So if you had any balance, then the vendor balance would represent a liability. So it is going to be a liability and a current liability. On the other hand, the customer's account is going to be an asset and a current asset. So if there were any balance in these accounts, we will post them in these respective places. Then you have bad debts. Bad debt is a loss. So this loss is going to be shown under the indirect expenses. So bad debts 10 is going to be shown here. I will write somewhere here. So bad debts is 10. Next is rent. Rent is an expense and this is an indirect expense. Although, you know, one might come back and argue saying we do not know if this rent is for the, you know, factory space or for but let's assume a regular trading business here, and if you don't have clarity, you can put rent in the indirect expenses. But, you know, in practicality, you would know where this money is being spent. So rent 20, done. Next is interest income 10. This goes into incomes and this is also a non-operating income. Any income other than sale is non-operating income unless otherwise you have you are into that business as well. You're into multiple businesses. So interest income is 10. It is going to be written here. Interest income in the second half of the profit and loss account. The amount was 10. Then is depreciation 10. Depreciation has been regarded as an expense and as an indirect expense. So depreciation will be shown here. Then you have building. Building is an asset and it is a non-current asset as well. So 60 goes to balance sheet under building. 60. Also note that even under non-current asset, you can have the categorization of tangible and intangible assets. So there is more, detailed, more granularity involved as well. But for now, this is sufficient. Then you have a bank loan of 200. This is a liability and a non-current liability, 200 bank loan. So in the balance sheet, I'm going to write bank loan. Bank loan is also 200. So there you go. We have posted the items to the different places where they need to go. I think one mistake that we made is shareholders' capital was 100 and we have written it as 200. So let's make it 100 here. All right. So now all we need to do is to calculate the profit here. So we have 100 as the total on this side. So we close this using the convention of closing an account, and you have 100 total. So the gross profit carried down is nil. You don't make any profit. You are selling it at the same cost. Then you bring forward the gross profit, which is zero, and seems like you have more expenses than the income. So there is a loss, so which is all right. So let us do the total here. You have 40 and 40 here. So this means there is a 30 loss. So this is net loss during the year. So 30 rupee is the loss, and this loss is going to, so if there is any profit that contributes to shareholders' capital, since there is a loss here, it should reduce the capital of the shareholders. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring this capital here. So capital was 100 and we're going to take out the loss during the year, which is 30. So this becomes 70. So what we've done is, in since there was no profit, the profit cannot be contributing to the capital of the shareholder. There is a loss. The capital has to be reduced, and that's what we did. Capital has been reduced here. The total of the liability side is 270, and total of the asset side is 270. The accounting equation says assets are equal to liabilities. So assets are actually equal to liabilities. We just took, you know, 14 typical transactions, representative transactions, and we have gone from the very first book journal to ledger to trial balance, and now we have prepared balance sheet and income statement, and we have seen that the accounting equation holds. Accounting equation holds, the double entry system holds. Trial balances total was equal, and the total of the liabilities is also equal to the asset side. So there you go. That is a quick show of the process of accounting cycle. That is how a transaction, if you remember the first transaction, which was the shareholders bring in money to the business, that amount has been populated here. The loan has been populated here, the building is here, bank balance is here. However, if you look behind this 210, this 210 can be mapped back to the ledger posting, where a lot of transactions were involved, about 5 to 10 transactions were involved, after which you reached at this amount of 210. So the final numbers, after you do the accounting cycle process, the final numbers are shown on the balance sheet. And balance sheet is a statement, and I've said statement is true as on a date. So balance sheet is prepared as on the last day of any financial year. So let's say 31st March 2020. On this date, the bank balance is 210. And if you want to know what happened to the bank balance during the year, you can go back to the bank account. We prepared the bank account, and you can know more details. So all of that, all of journal, ledger and trial balance is the back end to this front end. The front end is the balance sheet. This is what is shown to the public, the income statement here and the balance sheet. Also in the profit and loss account, what is shown is total purchases are 100. However, we know that 50 purchases were cash, 50 were in on credit. But none of that is shown here. Again, this is a front end. This is what the stakeholders are going to view. And if somebody needs more information, if you are the management, a member of the management team in the organization, and you need to view how these purchases were made during the year, or what was monthly rent and so on, you could go to the ledger of rent account, bad debts account, depreciation account, purchase account or sale account, and look at their details. That's what I wanted to discuss in this video. Now you know the whole process of accounting cycle and how it produces this outcome, which is called final accounts. I'll see you in the next video.